So, I'm sure by now, you have heard of the news that the government is about to phase out EasyLink and NETS FreshPay cards for public transport fare payments. Which means, unless you upgrade your card to a SimplyGo card, you won't be able to take public transport starting the 1st of June. And unsurprisingly, with all the kiasu people rushing to upgrade their cards immediately, Singaporeans have once again managed to DDoS another server. Lol. But that aside, by upgrading to SimplyGo, this meant that we can no longer see our card balance whenever we tap in or tap out. Actually, if you think about it, the SimplyGo word might mean simply go out lah, see what see. Understandably, many people were super unhappy with this move. Why you no show me my card balance? So, a few days later, LTA came out and say that it's actually technically possible to show your card balance, but this would create longer queues. Huh? What? So, in this video, I will explain what's actually going on, such as why EasyLink can display card balance but SimplyGo can't? Why will this create longer queues? Then at the end, I will even show you a real programming solution that I came up with because, you know, I'm something of a programmer myself. Also, do join my Telegram chat group to discuss or ask any questions that you may have. Alright, let's jump right in. So, here's why EasyLink can show card balance while SimplyGo can't. EasyLink is basically a prepaid cash card where the money is stored in your card. So, if you lose your card, you will lose all that money that you have topped up in your card. On the other hand, the SimplyGo card is sort of like a debit card. There's no money in the card. Instead, the card is linked to your SimplyGo account, which is stored online in the cloud. So, if you lose your card, you can just link a new card and you can continue using the new card. Though, it gets even more confusing. First, there's the SimplyGo EasyLink card where you can top up money to your SimplyGo account. Then, there's the SimplyGo NETS FreshPay card which basically does the same thing. The SimplyGo contactless bank card where it deducts the money straight from your bank account. And the SimplyGo credit card where it charges the payment to your credit card. But for this video, I'll just be talking about the SimplyGo EasyLink card where you can top up money to your SimplyGo account and use that money because this is the one which everyone is angry about. So, why can't SimplyGo just show our card balance? Can is can, but you have network issues. Datian from Reddit drew some really nice diagrams which explain the problem and also what you can do if you want to show the balance for SimplyGo. Basically, you tap your card, the card reader contacts the server does all the calculations and returns the balance back to the card reader, then shows you the card balance. So simple. However, because there's a server involved, you also need to take into account network issues. What if during the peak period, everyone wants to tap out the same time? Or you will have server lag? Or what if the bus goes past CBD and the tall buildings block your network? Or you have no network? Or what if another Singtel building catches fire? You get the idea. That's why LTA says that while it's technically possible, this will lead to longer queues. But then, how are other countries solving this issue? Surely by now, someone would have already found a solution, right? Quick pause. Did you know that besides Webull's awesome deals, Webull also has a paper trading feature which allows you to practice your trading skills and test out different strategies. You can find the paper trading feature by going to menu where you'll find paper trade. And here, you'll be able to test out different trading strategies without losing any money. For example, maybe you saw some technical analysis that shows that right now there's a short-term bearish signal, but you aren't sure whether you can trust the signal or not. In that case, you can use PaperTrade to test your trades. Webull paper trading feature supports trading on both stocks and options. And if you have lost money, no worries. You can reset the net account value back to the full amount and continue with your paper trades. Then, once you're ready, you can move on to doing real trades with the knowledge that you have gained from the experience of paper trading. Also, if you sign up using my link down below, subscribe at least $500 into Moneyboo and keep the money there for 30 days, you win 25 free shares worth anywhere between $3 to $500 each. Besides that, there's also a Moneyboo promotion where you can earn up to $3,000 by subscribing at least $2,000 in Moneyboo and fulfilling the requirements. Webull also launched a new transfer promo from which you could possibly get up to $2,000 worth of free shares or more by fulfilling the requirements. So, if you are interested in trying out Webull, do sign up to them using my link down below. With that being said, let's get back to the video. So for Japan, even though you can add your Suica card to your Apple Wallet and top up your card online, in the end, it's still an EasyLink card. So the balance is kept in the card. For Hong Kong, while they recently started to support contactless credit card and mobile e-wallets, you will need to tap the card at a separate gate which is enabled for contactless payments. In London, while you can pay using your credit card, it doesn't show you any info. Instead, you will need to get an Oyster account to see your transactions. And in New York, even though it accepts credit cards, it also doesn't show you any transaction info. So basically, no one has actually managed to solve this problem yet. Or maybe I wasn't able to find. However, for all the countries that I mentioned, this is not an issue. Why? Because they are still supporting both the EasyLink method and the SimplyGo method. And on top of that, their EasyLink cards have a lot more use cases than just paying for public transport. For example, you can use Japan's Suica card at convenience stores, vending machines, coin lockers, and even restaurants. Same for the Hong Kong's Octopus card, which is widely accepted everywhere. Just look at this chart. The EasyLink cards practically support everything. Even Malaysia's Touch and Go is more advanced than Singapore's. Meanwhile, the prepaid card system is fragmented in Singapore. First, you have the SimplyGo EasyLink and Nets prepaid card, which can only be used for public transport and retail, but not for motoring. Then, you have the non-upgraded EasyLink card, which can only be used for motoring from June onwards. Then, the Nets FlashPay card, which can only be used for retail and motoring. Then now, you have the new SimplyGo system. Hosebo. But then, why is the government planning to phase out EasyLink and Nets FlashPay cards? Like, everything is working sui sui wen leh. Why suddenly phase out? Save money lor. According to LTA, in December 2023, there were 2.6 million adult fare transactions for SimplyGo each day, compared to just 1.5 million transactions made using EasyLink and Nets FlashPay cards. Basically, 2 in 3 adult fare transactions are already on the SimplyGo system. And given that the legacy card-based ticketing system for adult commuters is nearing the end of its operational lifespan, instead of renewing the old card-based ticketing system, which is very costly, LTA has decided to just transition all adult commuters to the SimplyGo platform. Though, what's interesting is that this phasing out will not affect passengers using concession cards, including seniors and students. So technically, are they still running two systems? I don't know. So how can LTA solve this issue then? Other than, you know, pretend like nothing happened and just roll back their announcement? Personally, I am supportive of this change. Because if you can save costs, then the government will have more money to use elsewhere, like CDC voucher. But you also need to first solve the no fare display issue ma. So let's improve on Datio's solution. And here's my solution. In order to cater for the network issue, you will need to introduce something called asynchronous programming. Basically, everything is done in parallel and you don't need to wait for the server. By the way, this is what every online multiplayer game is doing now. Whenever you do something, you don't have to wait for a reply from the server. The game will first update the display, then later updates itself whenever there's a reply from the server. But back to the solution. So when you first tap in, the card reader doesn't have to send your data straight away to the server. It can queue up the message, then only send when there's a network connection. Same for the server. It doesn't have to return the card balance immediately, but will only return the balance when there's a network connection. Why? Because after you tap in, the bus or the train will have at least 30 seconds before it arrives at the next stop, unless the bus driver is speeding lah. Then that one different story. During that 30 seconds, you will have plenty of time for the card reader and the server to talk to each other. Then once you arrive at your stop, you can tap out, the card reader calculates the fare for you, then displays the fare and the card balance immediately. And you get off the ride. Then after that, the card reader can send the data to the server when it has the chance to do so. So that's how you solve the SimplyGo problem without creating a queue. But what if during the whole journey, the card reader is unable to connect to the server? Yes, you have this issue. But with our nationwide outdoor service coverage being at 99.5%, this issue will only affect 0.5% of the commuters rather than 100% of the commuters now. In that case, just don't display any fares to them and just tell them to check the card balance via ticketing machines or the SimplyGo app lor. Or you know, just get the Standard Chartered smart card. This card will let you earn either a 6% cashback or 5.6 miles per dollar on your public transport spends. Plus, you will also get to earn rewards on your fast food spends, coffee and toast spends, digital subscriptions. The card has no annual fee, no minimum spend, and if you pay for your credit card bills via GIRO through HSBC EGA, you will earn another 1% cashback. And oh yeah, there are some sign-up rewards if you sign up using my link. Though, with that being said, this fix is easier said than done. But with SimplyGo being a revolutionary e-payment system, And with Singapore being one of the most technologically advanced countries in the world, I'm quite certain that the team behind this will eventually be able to find a solution. Anyway, that's all for this video. Hopefully, you found this useful. Like, share, and subscribe as I'll be posting new videos every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday.